नमस्ते, इज द गवर्नमेंट गोइंग टू प्राइवेटाइज द लाइफ इंश्योरेंस कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ इंडिया? Perhaps the most prestigious public sector undertaking. The government says, no, it's not going to privatize the LIC. But then what is it doing if it is not going to privatize? It says that it is only going to go for the initial public offer, IPO of LIC. That is what exactly Anurag Thakur, Minister of State Finance and Corporate Affairs. Of course, his portfolio changed now, all right. He said on the floor of the house that government is not going to privatize. Then initial public offer, what is that? Selling stake of the public sector life insurance corporation. That means a portion, a small amount of the stake of the LIC. But selling a stake, ending the monopoly control of the government of India and the LIC, doesn't it mean a dent on the ownership of the government on the LIC behemoths? It is privatizing a part. So it is part privatization. Where will this end? Government is all set to go for wholesale privatization wherever it is possible. Although it now says that it is not going to privatize LIC, there are fears, and the fears are not unfounded. But why at all it is going to do this part privatization, IPO privatization or whatever it is? Is not LIC serving the public purpose anymore? Is not LIC giving enough returns to the government? Is not LIC fulfilling its establishment objectives? So let us look at the achievements through LIC to see whether it is justified to go for privatization or to hold control on that. Before that, a little bit of history, the genesis of Life Insurance Corporation of India. What happened before the nationalization of the life insurance segment? How were the private companies performing? Because we are going for privatization. The first life insurance in India came in 1818. That is Oriental Life Insurance. It came from the United Kingdom. It came to serve the European community, not Indians. And the first life insurance did not cover the lives of Indians because the colonial government and the colonial time businesses considered Indian lives to be substandard. They didn't want to take a risk on Indian lives, so they did not cover the Indian lives. It took a lot of struggle, agitation and efforts. Prominently, persons like Babu Motilal Seal, that you cover Indians' lives. Of course, at last those companies agreed to cover the Indian lives, but still they maintained that the lives of Indians were substandard, so they charged higher premiums, exceedingly high premiums, because they maintained they were substandard. In course of time, that anomaly has gone all right. But the insurance sector was under the private control, and the inefficiencies, fraud, corruption grown in leaps and bounds under the private ownership. There were so many frauds. Just to list a few, what happened before the nationalization of the insurance and during pre-independence days, even a little after independence also, 25 frauds were noted. No, not frauds, 25 liquidations. frauds are many more. And 80 insurance companies did not file the statutory returns. They were supposed to file the returns to the authorities giving the information data. They did not do, even they didn't file. 245 life insurance and 108 general insurance failed the policy holders. Later, after independence, during Jawaharlal Nehru time, a commission was appointed, Vivian Bose committee. He found that there was large-scale money laundering, accommodating sister concerns. What is this? The private companies in business also organized insurance companies, and they made false claims on these accommodating own or sister concerns. He gave the examples. One was Ruby General Insurance of Birla's and Bharat Insurance of Dalmia's resorted to these frauds. So they helped the sister concerns and failed the general public. Then what is the solution? Many companies failed, many companies cropped up, liquidated, and there was no trust to go for insurance. Then at that time in 1956, the government of India, to protect the public interest, it has organized the Life Insurance Corporation of India, amalgamating 245 entities. Of them, 154 were Indian and 16 foreign life insurance companies. In addition, 75 provident fund societies all put together, 245. And how much money that government invested to form this big life insurance, big today, Life Insurance Corporation of India? 5 crore rupees. Of course, later the 5 crore is enhanced to 100 crore, but that was no burden on the government because the government has been earning much, much more than this 100 crores every year. So it was internally generated. So that was no additional burden to the government. So there was no need also to make it 100 crore. And now the authorized capital is 25,000 crore. These are not necessary because the Life Insurance Corporation is government-owned company and all the policy holders are guaranteed by the government. The sovereign guarantee to the policy holders is given under Section 37 of the Life Insurance Corporation of India Act. So then what did the Life Insurance Corporation LIC achieved with this 5 crore rupees investment of the government? What did it do? Life Insurance Corporation of India operates from Mumbai headquarters. It has 8 zonal offices, 113 divisional offices, 2048 branches, 1526 satellite offices, 1178 mini offices. Besides, it has also branches in other countries abroad. It has branches in Fiji, Mauritius, United Kingdom. Also, it has joint ventures abroad. Bahrain, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Kenya, Saudi Arabia, and Bangladesh. This growth, the spread, despite not the government support, government's withdrawal of support, so to say. From 1999 onwards, the private competition was introduced. Despite that competition, the Life Insurance Corporation of India has been growing phenomenally. Then what is the Life Fund? The Life Fund, as of 2019-20, 31,14,496.05 crore, that much. So the balance sheet, the 30 lakh crore balance sheet, makes Life Insurance Corporation second largest financial service institution only after State Bank of India, next to State Bank of India. State Bank of India's balance sheet size is 39.51 lakh crore. And then the sum assured today of LIC is 56,86,035 crore. Then how many employees are working in the Life Insurance Corporation of India? It employs 1,14,498. In addition, 10,80,809 active agents. Out of total 12,08,826 agents. So in all, LIC directly provides employment to 13.23 lakh persons. And all this, 5 crore rupees government spending on that. Then what is the market share? Now that the private life insurance allowed, there are 24 insurance companies against the monopoly of only LIC that was broken by the government that time. Now ownership also is being broken or is under threat now because of that IPO. That may be the beginning. Then the share today is 68.74% total first year premium and 75.90 new business policies in 2019-20. So it's not small. Then its service, is it bad to the people? It is excellent. I'm not telling this. People said this, not today. They said in 1993, that time when to bring the reforms in the insurance sector, government appointed for life insurance, Malhotra Committee, as you may remember. Malhotra Committee to be objective employed morgue to go into this and see if Life Insurance Corporation of India is doing good job. The response of the people was that 97% of the people responded it to be excellent, good. That continues. So there is no problem with this. Then is it not giving enough profits to the government? 95% of the surplus goes to the policy holders. That is not the case with the private sector. It is less than that. And only 5% gives to the government. That 5% in 1 year, the dividend what government pocketed in 2019-20 was 2,697.74 crore. In addition, government that year got 10,225.24 as taxes. So this much government is getting. Then even the real estate assets of the Life Insurance Corporation of India, it has many own buildings. So many branches it has in Mumbai, it has offices, Delhi, Metropolis. Cities and towns conservatively estimated on their books the value of real estate assets is 1,750 crore, but the actual market value could be many times more than this. Then what are the other achievements? Let us look at them briefly. Earnings of Life Insurance Corporation of India, 6,15,883 crore, and institutional investment of Life Insurance Corporation, it is the biggest institutional investor. 31st March 2020, how much did it invest in the stock markets? 30,69,941.67 crore. So 30.69 lakh crore. This is bigger than the aggregate investment of the all the foreign institutional investors put together. Then LIC doesn't do only insurance business. It has diversified its activities. To list them, you know that LIC has LIC Housing Finance Limited. I am not giving the details of its performance and balance sheet details of this because time constraint. Brief video, One is LIC Housing Finance Limited, LIC Mutual Fund Assets Management, LIC Pension Fund, LIC Card Services, and IDBI. Government made LIC to buy the IDBI. 51% of the stake of IDBI is held by the Life Insurance Corporation of India. It took it over in January 2019, so it also owns a bank. Then now it is IPO and disinvestment. But LIC has been helping the government in its disinvestment programs substantially. In 2012, when government went for the disinvestment of ONGC, 5% of ONGC stake, 90% of it, 4.4%, it works more than that, was taken by Life Insurance Corporation. Similarly, in 2019, NMDC disinvestment stake, 6,000 crore out of 9,928 crore, which accounts to 60% was taken by LIC. Then NTPC, 4,263 crore out of 8,480 crore. Then Steel Authority of India Limited, sale, 71% in 2013. BHEL, 2,685 crore in 2014. Then Indian Oil Corporation, 8,000 crore. Coal India Limited, 7,000 crore. GIC, 8,000 crore. New India Assurance Company, 6,500 crore in 2017, HAL 2,900 crore, and as I told you, IDBI stake 51% in 2019. So, what do these figures speak? The data tell us that the LIC performed to the maximum satisfaction of the people. The social security it has provided to 29 crore people. That is roughly 25% of the population. Is this a small achievement? Then it helped for the economic development by investing lakhs of crores of rupees. Also, for the public sector disinvestment, LIC's stake, as we have seen, is substantial. Now, after privatizing the LIC, I don't know who is going to substitute for LIC to support the government. So, let's hope that the government will rethink in the public interest. Will it do that? Or is it going to be hoping against the hope because now the government's goal is privatization. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe to this channel. Please support me. If you support me, I will continue to bring more and more videos like these. So support your channel. I am taking up our issues. It is free. What all you need to do is to click on that subscribe button below this video. After that, please don't forget to click on the bell icon to get the notifications as and when I upload a new video to your channel. Thank you.